I'm here on Green Island, on the Great Barrier Reef, just offshore Queensland in Australia. And Green Island is a coral cay island, and is part of the coral reef system that makes up the Barrier Reef here in Australia. Now, reefs build up over many thousands, if not millions of years, and they have a relationship with sea level change. Because over the thousands of years that reefs have been developing, sea level has been going up and down. During ice ages, glacial stages, when a lot of the water in the sea is taken out, is extracted to build up the continental ice sheet, the sea level falls. And of course, reef islands and reef systems such as I'm standing on today would be left high and dry. And indeed, the Barrier Reef system here and elsewhere in the world, they actually form hills. With caves running through them, karst features from the dissolution of the limestone coral during those sea level low stands. Now when sea level rises, of course, it then floods in the reef area that was left exposed during the glacial, and the coral migrates back onshore to recolonize the old dead coral reef. And so through cycles of glacial stages, reefs develop through these low stands to sea level high stands to produce the reefs that we see today. Now, there are three different types of reef. There's the ribbon reef, which occurs right out there on the edge of the continental shelf. And it's thought that they are the ones that persist during when sea level is lower in the glacial stage, and they form a ribbon right along the glacial coastline. And as sea level then rises, those ribbon, linear ribbon reefs that along the continental shelf simply grow up with that rising sea level. So we have those right out on the continental shelf. But then further towards the land, where we have those old hills of coral, limestone and so on, they end up being quite oval-shaped reef systems, things we call patch reefs. And in fact, the reef that Green Island here sits upon is an example of a patch reef. And then when you get further to the land, right up against the coast, you can sometimes have coral right up against the land, something we call fringing reefs. But as I said, we're stood here in Green Island, which is in fact a patch reef system. Now, the way that an island comes into being on top of a reef is due to the processes of erosion and then deposition. Because when the coral out there lives, it's made up of living polyps, which have algal symbionts within them, and those algal symbionts photosynthesize with light and produce food for the coral. So the coral has got to live in the photic zone, the very top layer of the ocean. So it's always very close to the surface. Now, of course, that's where wave activity has its strongest impact. So as waves go across the ocean, they can erode the edge of the coral, particularly the windward side of the patch reef, and they can erode out the front or the windward side of the reef. And blocks of limestone and pulverized coral limestone can then form what we call coral sand, which can be quite coarse, or as we can see here, it's relatively fine. Now that can be swept up by cyclones and big wave events, so that it's then concentrated in sort of sandbars, patches of sand in the middle of the reef, perhaps then surrounded by lagoons before you get to the outer part of the reef. And once they're established, these sand bars, seabirds will visit them, and through their droppings deposit seeds and also fertilizer onto the sand unit. And in that way, they start to become vegetated. And once they become vegetated, with the type of vegetation you can see behind me here, then the sediment is much better held in position. It doesn't get swept away so much. And the island can become more stable. Now, of course, around the outside of the island, as we can see here, the waves do get up, and they can prune back the vegetation and resulting in the fallen trees that are just falling out of the sediment, basically, that makes up the coral cay. Now, the coral cay itself Because it's made up of this very coarse, defined coral sand, of course, coral limestone is made up of calcium carbonate, which can easily dissolve. And so, as rain falls on this sediment surface, it can dissolve. And as it dissolves, that dissolved limestone actually migrates through the sediment column and ends up at the bottom, where it can actually solidify and cement the sand to form what we see here, which is beach rock. And if we have a look down here, you can see that it's quite a hard, well, it's a solid rock, but that's coral clay sand, that's simply been cemented by the dissolution of the sand from above, and those waters percolating to the base of the sand unit, where they are then cemented in place to form this really solid crete, which adds again to the stability of the coral Kay Island. If you just wander down to the low shore area, you can also see that dissolution in evidence as well, actually acting on the beach rock. You can see down here that it's quite jagged, and you can see that there's some holes in it where in fact water is redissolving this limestone and it's putting back in the water. So the islands and coral reefs in general are related to sea level rise, climate change, but also once the processes, wave processes, erode the end of the windward side of the reefs, deposit the sand in the middle, these Kay Islands can build up. But on the leeward side of these islands, the coral diversity and preservation is much higher. Lovely stacks of Pyrites coral and other species. Which are lovely stacks, like columns of limestone, of coral limestone out there. So a fascinating environment, and one that's very in tune with climate change, sea level rise, and the process.